Hello, boys and girls. I want to welcome you back to Solid Rock Children's Church. I hope you've had an amazing week. I hope that you're having a great weekend, whether you're on the couch in your pajamas or you've been playing some games, or if you've just been chilling out and you had a big sleep. I hope you're ready for our lesson today. So last week, Olu was talking to us about Esther and God's plan for her life. And I really enjoyed it, and I hope you guys did too. But this week we're going to be talking about Jericho and how Joshua and the Israelites came and took down Jericho, the walls. You know the song that sometimes we've sang when we were in Sunday school saying, Joshua marched around the walls of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. I bet a lot of you know that song. So that's the story that we're going to be talking about today. I can't wait. I'll see you soon.
The Faithful Hall of Fame, Joshua. This is Joshua.
Oh, hey.
Joshua was the leader of the Israelites, who God used to bring his people to the Promised Land.
Yeah, let's do it.
When God told Joshua it was time to take the Promised Land, Joshua sent spies into the city of Jericho. While those spies were in Jericho,
come on!
They were protected by a woman named Rahab. The spies promised to spare Rahab and her family when they took back the land.
Yay!
And she hung a scarlet cord from her window to remind them of their promise.
See you soon!
Now the Israelites had crossed the Jordan and were camped near the town of Jericho.
Hey!
Hello!
One day, Joshua looked up.
Huh?
And there was a man standing before him.
Hello.
The man said, I am the commander of the army of the Lord. Joshua asked what the man wanted to tell him, and the Lord said he wanted Joshua to take the city of Jericho.
Alright.
But that Joshua needed to follow his instructions exactly.
You got it.
Jericho was shut for fear of the Israelites.
Yeah, went home? Yeah, well.
No one came out and no one came in. So the Lord told Joshua to gather his soldiers and march around the city for 6 days.
Hey.
The priests were to take the Ark of the Covenant, and seven priests were to go in front of it, blowing a ram's horn. On the seventh day, they were to march around the city seven times and blow the horn. Then all the people of Israel were to give a great shout.
Then what?
And then the city walls would fall.
Whoa! Yeah, let's do it!
So Joshua said, shout, for the Lord has given you the city. And the people did shout. And the walls did fall.
Let's go!
The Israelites overtook the city of Jericho as God had commanded.
Rahab!
They remembered Rahab because of her faithfulness. Joshua was faithful in carrying out God's commands, and the Israelites took many other cities as God told them they would.
Oh, nice!
For God will never fail to fulfill his promises. So the Israelites came to live in the land that God had promised Abraham, Isaac, Israel, Joseph, and Moses many years ago.
Welcome back, boys and girls. I really hope you've enjoyed that video. It's such a great story, so let's talk a little bit about it. So the Israelites are ready to claim the land that God had done for them, which was Jericho, and he told them to go and take back Jericho. But Jericho had a massive wall around it, and no armies or any weapons were able to get past the wall. And they didn't have like big army tanks and trucks like our armies do now. And even then, we don't even know if it would have been able to take down the wall, because the weapon that the Israelites had was God. So God gave them the instructions on what they had to do, which was when they went around and they had to walk and praise God, and they had the priests with their trumpets. And then on the final day, they all shouted. And the wall came tumbling down. Isn't that amazing, boys and girls? So the thing that we can take from the story of Joshua and Jericho is that there was such a big wall and nobody could get past that wall. But with God and what them doing what God told them what to do, they were able to conquer Jericho. And just in our lives, is we have things in the way and obstacles in our lives, but with God and when we follow his instructions and we're obedient to him, we are able to conquer, and nothing and no obstacle can ever stand in our way. Isn't that amazing? I really hope you enjoyed today's message. I hope that you can even sing the song if you know the words with your family today, or with your brothers and sisters, or just on your own. I recommend that you look it up and get a grown-up to help you to find the song. I hope that you have an amazing week, and we're going to finish off now with our Bible verse that I have for you. So our Bible verse for this week is Psalm chapter 24, verse 10. And it says, "Who is this King of glory? The Lord Almighty, he is the King of glory." Now, boys and girls, so I want you to learn that for next week and learn it off by heart. And I want you to look up Joshua chapter 5 in the Bible and read this story, not only from our videos and from our lesson today, but read it for yourself. Have a good week. Bye.
Hail Jesus, you're my King.
Hail Jesus, you're my King.
Your life frees me to sing.
Your life frees me to sing.
I will praise you all my day.
I will praise you all my day.
You're perfect in all your ways.
You're perfect in all your ways.
Hail Jesus, you're my Lord.
Hail Jesus, you're my Lord.
I will obey your word.
Jesus.